historical the back the historical facts.
Now, which Chango is this?
This is a Chango, El Gran Putas.
This is Chango.
Yes. Manuel Zapata Vivella de Colombia, Afro-Colombian, if you will, because he's very proud of his African roots, passed away, became an ancestor, in the belief that he practiced, you don't die, you just go to become an ancestor. That is a light to guide other people, like he is guiding us tonight. And you, as you will see, into a different view of our world, that is the African diaspora in the Americas. This Tertulia series, the object of it, is to link, to create links in the diaspora, because the diaspora didn't happen only in the United States or in the Caribbean, as is wrongly thought. It actually happened to the whole continent. People, African people helped build the whole continent. And it influenced every part of the life that is here. Now, one thing that I was not expecting to do tonight, and we will do, was to speak a few minutes about Blas Jimenez. Manuel Zapata came to New York And he was totally broke. He had walked all the way from Colombia to Mexico to see how things were going. In Mexico, he stayed for a while, he worked. He had just about finished his medical training. And so he ended up coming to the States from the Mexican border to the north. He did not walk. He actually rode a train. So he arrived to New York broke. He went to Harlem. He knocked in Langston Hughes' house, and he was welcomed like if it was an old-time brother. That's how he describes it. It's heartbreaking because very few people know about these friendships that work and that actually developed intellectuality throughout the continent and the planet.
He emphasizes very much about the content because Africans and First Nations. And this is a member of the scene from the book about this encounter. This is the birth of who we are in the Americas. All of us. Because the Americas, I mean, he covers all the way from South America, as you see, to Harlem. That's the end of the novel. All of these ideas perpetuate through your educational setting, through generations, and you have to follow. You have to follow the path towards emancipation. And this is the encounter of the Montu philosophy.
The Indian women waited on the beach for the Montu child in order to breastfeed him. Gently, I moistened his body with saliva in order to smooth his tendons, and let loose, he swam in search of his new destiny that Shango had prepared for him.
He plays with languages. He goes beyond, you know, in terms of the Spanish language, he plays with the grammatical structures. He plays with the, we see the spirits talking through the novel and horses.
Yes, the work has been translated to French.
Jonathan Tittler, he has translated the novel. I don't know how he did it because the novel is so complex that they just...
Now, which novel is this?
This is a Chango, El Gran Puta.
This is Chango.
Yes.
So this is not the one. I'm seeing in the film something about a bad dude.
This is the one.
That is the same one.
It's the same one. This is his masterpiece. Part of the African mysticism, the African religions in America, yeah. Vodou is practiced all the way from the Caribbean to New York. The Vodou in the novel plays a very important role in terms of the liberation of what we know today as Haiti. The Vodou was the initiation of the revolution in Haiti. Bookman initiated the whole movement through Vodou.